Today marks 20 years since September 11th, 2001, one of the most tragic days in our nation's history. On that day, America fell victim to unprovoked terrorist attacks, which took the lives of nearly 3,000 Americans and injured another 6,000, including firefighters, paramedics, and police officers. Many of us can vividly remember the events that unfolded at the World Trade Center, the Pentagon, and the heroic story of Flight 93. We watched many brave men and women running into danger in service of others, representing the true American spirit. Across our nation, we pause to remember the impact of 9/11 and how it forever changed our country. But this year's anniversary is even more significant, as it comes just days after the end of America's longest war. The past two decades have not been an easy chapter, nor have they been without setbacks and sacrifices. And while I have strong views, very strong views, about the unraveling that we've seen in the last few weeks, my message today is this. Our country is forever grateful to the nearly 800,000 Afghanistan war veterans, those who volunteered to wear our nation's uniform and fought to defend the freedoms that we hold dear. Their mission has not been in vain. We honor the heroism of over 2,400 service members who made the ultimate sacrifice during this war. And we pay special tribute to their families and loved ones who will carry on their memory. On this day, officially known now as the National Day of Service and Remembrance, my heart is with all of the families, loved ones, friends, and allies whose lives were changed on 9/11 and the 20 years that followed. Let us continue to honor and thank all of those who sacrificed so much by coming together as neighbors, as volunteers, to embody that spirit of service and community on this National Day of Unity. Let us not forget that we are a United States, and in our darkest moments, our common bonds are stronger than any fears. We are friends and neighbors, mothers and fathers, sons and daughters, and our politics ought not divide us. Fulfilling the promise America provides, not just to its citizens here at home, but to those suffering oppression across the world, requires each and every one of us to be better to each other, for each other. God bless you all.